ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയേഴ്സ്, ഹൗ ഇസ് ഇറ്റ് ഗോയിങ്? ആർ യു ഓക്കെ? ഹോപ്പ് ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ആർ കീപ്പിംഗ് ഫൈൻ ആൻഡ് വെൽ. ഇൻ ദ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ് വി ഹാവ് സം അസൈൻമെൻറ്റ്സ്. വാട്ട് അബൌട്ട് ദാറ്റ്? ഹാവ് യു കംപ്ലീറ്റഡ് ഇറ്റ്? ഐ എം ഷുവർ ദാറ്റ് ഓൾ ഓഫ് യു ഹാവ് ഡൺ ഇറ്റ്. ദ ഫസ്റ്റ് വൺ ഈസ് ടു റീഡ് മലാലാസ് വേർഡ്സ് ഇൻ ദ സർക്കിൾസ് ഗിവൺ ബിലോ ആൻഡ് ട്രൈ ടു പിക്ക് ഔട്ട് ദി കോഡ്സ് which carry similar ideas to that of Malala's words. We have to choose them from the balloons. Write the name of the person who has made the corresponding quote in the box given.
We call upon all governments to fight against terrorism and violence. This was said by Malala. It is similar to the words of Vladimir Putin. Terrorism has no nationality, no religion. A deal that goes against the dignity of women and their rights is unacceptable. This was said by Malala. It is similar to the words of George Carlin. Men are from earth, women are from earth. Deal with it. We call upon our sisters around the world to embrace the strength within themselves. It is said by Malala. It is similar to the words of Harriet Tubman. Always remember you have within you the strength, the patience and the passion to reach for the stars to change the world. We want schools and education for every child's bright future. This was said by Malala. It is similar to the words of Nelson Mandela. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world.
The second task is editing. A passage is given on page number 67. You have to read it and edit in your notebook. Here are some samples done by your friend. Have a look at it.
The second one is this. Read the passage given below. There are a few errors in it. They are underlined. Once upon a time, there lived a lovely princess with fair skin and blue eyes. She was so fair that she was named Snow White. Her mother dies when Snow White was a baby and her father married again. The skin was very pretty, but she was very cruel also. The wicked stepmother wanted to be the more beautiful lady in the kingdom, and she would often ask her magic mirror, "Mirror, mirror on the wall, who is the fairest of them all?" And the magic mirror would say, "You are, Your Majesty." But one day, the mirror replied, "Snow White is the fairest of them all." The wicked queen was very angry. "What a fair lady is Snow White." She became jealous of Snow White and ordered her huntsman to take Snow White to the forest and kill her. "I want you to bring back her heart," she ordered. But when the huntsman reached the forest with Snow White, he took pity on her and set her free. He killed a deer and took its heart to the wicked queen and told her that he had killed Snow White. Snow White wandered in the forest all night crying. I have done the editing like this. In the first sentence, the word princess is wrong. It should be corrected to P-R-I-N-C-E-S-S, princess. Second error is in the sentence, her mother dies. It should be corrected to her mother died. In the next sentence, the more beautiful lady is wrong. It should be corrected to the most beautiful lady. In the next part, something is missing. Who is the fairest of them all is a question. So, a question mark should be there after the word all. In the next part, what a fair lady is Snow White is in wrong order. It should be corrected to what a fair lady Snow White is. Lastly, the word dear is wrongly spelt. It should be corrected to D-E-E-R, dear. Okay friends, I think all of you have done this the same way.
Now, we are stepping into the third unit of our course book. Okay, what is the title of the unit? Yes, Glimpses of Nature. My dears, listen, what is going on there? A squabbling sound is there. Listen carefully, what is happening?
I may be small and little, but I come first when people pray. Look at me, I am the most beautiful. People crown me with the ring and they honor me as a king. I'm tall and big. You four fingers stand around me like guards around the king, and I'm the king of the fingers.
None of you are as useful as me. I direct, I point, I delete, and I am more useful to people.
I am also more important than you. If you want to write, lift, hold, catch, and pull anything, what would your dear fingers do without me? I mean to say, I am not good without you. The biggest thing is not I, he or you, but it's we. There is nothing we can do alone. We can do things together.
Yes, yes, we agree with you. If we five fingers are united and help each other, we will be happy.
Now I love you so much.
Together we walk, together we stand.
Dears, there is quarrel everywhere in the world. People are quarreling about different matters. It is, I am the richest, I am the cleverest, I am the most beautiful, I am the powerful. The arguments are going on like this. My dears, what do the fingers remind us? Everyone has his or her own importance. Each one is important in his or her own way. If we stand together, we can do better things and help each other. Then we all will be happy. Am I right? Dear friends, look at your palm. Are all the fingers same in size? Really not. We all are sure about that. In our palm, the different fingers are in different size. But which finger is important? We cannot say that. All the fingers are important in their own way. Different fingers has different functions. Am I right? My dears, shall I show you some hand signals? Can you say the meaning of that? Yes. What does this symbol mean? Yes. Victory. What about this one? It is about peace. Okay. My dears, nowadays we are familiar with different types of hand signals. Every day we are using different hand signals in our social media. നമ്മളെല്ലാവരും സ്ഥിരമായി പലതരത്തിലുള്ള സിഗ്നലുകൾ ഉപയോഗിക്കാറുണ്ടല്ലേ. നിങ്ങൾക്കെല്ലാവർക്കും അത് ഏറെ പരിചിതവുമാണ്. മൈ ഡിയേഴ്സ്, വി ആർ യൂസിങ് തംസ് അപ്പ് സിഗ്നൽ. വാട്ട് ഡസ് ഇറ്റ് മീൻ? ഇറ്റ് ഈസ് ടു അപ്രൂവ് സംതിങ്. ഓക്കെ ഡിയേഴ്സ്, ടുഡേ വി ഹാവ് എ ഗസ്റ്റ്. ഷി ഹാസ് ടു ഷെയർ സംതിങ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റിംഗ് ടു യു. ലെറ്റ്സ് വെൽക്കം അവർ ചിത്ര ടീച്ചർ.
Here we are going to make stitches using our palm. For this, we need chart paper, colors, brush and pump.
Take the colors you like, mix it with some water, dip your palm in it, print your palm on the chart paper. Now we get a beautiful tree. Thank you, Chitra teacher. My dears, what did you see? Yeah, making printing using palms. It is palm printing. Making beautiful pictures using our palms. Okay. Here we saw a palm printing of a tree. Do you like this? Oh, you like this very much. Is it interesting? Yeah, we can make many things using our palms and fingers. What are the things that we can make? Adhe prakrathiyilulla niravadhi vastukalude chithrangal nammude viralukalum kaigalum kaippathikalum upayogichu namukku nirmikkanavu. Look here. Here is a beautiful picture of a peacock made by our palms. It is very interesting, isn't it? നിങ്ങൾക്ക് എല്ലാവർക്കും ഇത് ഇഷ്ടപ്പെട്ടു അല്ലേ? Yes, my dears, today you have an interesting task. Use your palms and fingers to make beautiful picture about nature. And you have to make a write-up about your picture and send to your teacher. Okay? I'm sure all of you will do it. My dears, there are many words related to our palms. Do you know that? Here it is. What will you say, our small finger or little finger? Yes, we say pinky. There are many more things here about our palms. Okay, my dears, all our fingers are equally important. Like that, all the creatures in the world are equally important. Each one has its own importance. No one is inferior or superior to any other. Okay? Here is a story for you. Watch this.
There lived an elephant in a forest. He He loved to play in the water in the pond with his trunk. The other animals always teased him. The monkey said,
"Hi, fat guy, you are a useless fellow. You can't do nothing useful to others. Look, I can climb up the trees and pluck fruits."
The elephant worried so much. He thought, "Yes, the monkey is right. I'm a useless fellow." One day, the cow said to him,
"I provide milk for others. You are a useless fellow, my elephant."
The elephant worried again. The elephant met a honeybee. The bee said to the elephant,
"I am very small, but I can collect honey for others. You can't do anything for others. You are a useless fellow."
One day, the forest caught fire. All the animals were scared. They did not know what to do. But the elephant suddenly gathered as much water as he can in his trunk and put out the fire. He saved the life of the others. That day, the other animals realized that he is also useful. They were ashamed to ridicule the elephant.
"Sorry, my dear friend,
the animal said in a single voice. The animal selected him as the leader from that day onwards.
My dears, how was the story? Did you like it? What do the story remind us? Everybody in the world is equally important. Every creature has its own importance. Right, friends? In our textbook, there is a poem having the same idea. Take page number 75. Dears, what is the title of the poem? Yes, The Mountain and the Squirrel. Can you tell me who wrote this poem? Yes, Ralph Waldo Emerson. He is an American poet. Here is something more about Emerson. Listen.
Ralph Waldo Emerson was an American poet, essayist, and philosopher. He was born on May 25th in Boston, Massachusetts. After studying at Harvard, he spent a short time for teaching. He was born and brought up in Boston. He was a social critic and a champion of individualism. His main works are Self-Reliance, The Oversoul, The May Day, and so on. He wrote a lot about the relationship between man and nature.
Dears, now look at the picture. What can you see here? Yeah, a mountain and a small squirrel. Mala, annanodu endavum paranjittundavuga? What are they doing? Can you identify? Yes, they are saying something to each other. Are they friends? Or they are quarreling? Can you say me? Okay. Now here is the poem on the screen. And you can listen it also.
The mountain and the squirrel had a quarrel. And the former called the latter little pig. One replied, "You are doubtless very big, but all sorts of things and weather must be taken in together to make up a ear and a spear. And I think it no disgrace to occupy my place. If I am not so large as you, you are not so small as I, and not half so spry. I'll not deny you make a very pretty the squirrel track. Talents differ, all is well and wisely put. If I cannot carry forest on my back, neither can you crack a nut.
I think now you got some idea about the poem. Okay? Yes. Now take your textbook. You can read the poem as many times as you can and mark the difficult words and expressions. We can clear the doubts in the next class. Today you have two tasks. What were that? First one, you have to make a palm printing based on the nature and prepare a write-up. Second one, you have to read the poem The Mountain and the Squirrel many times and mark your doubts. Okay, dears, that's all for today. Bye-bye. See you.